The state of your life is nothing more than a reflection of your state of mind. And that is the thought for today. Welcome to 7 Good Minutes. I'm Clyde Lee Dennis. Thanks for joining me for what I believe will be 7 of the most enriching minutes of your day. In today's episode of 7 Good Minutes, we learn how changing your mental state can change your life. Enjoy.
People are not one way. We are a reflection of the states we're living in. When you're in a frustrated state, an overwhelmed state, a tired state, your brain processes completely differently than if you're in a passionate state, whether you're feeling determined, whether you're feeling committed, whether you feel completely resolved. So learning to change the leader's state, learning how to change your own state. Because, you know, people, one of the silliest questions I get asked is, you're not really that happy, are you? You have bad days, don't you? Of course they have, you know, bad times. But I don't have bad days anymore, and it's not BS. It's because I've trained myself like an athlete to go in these peak states so often that they're just natural for me. It's like building a muscle. So it's not like I'm so smart or I'm just so positive. It's just like, why would I waste my time stressing out? I have a 90-second rule. I'll stress for 90 seconds, but stress is not going to solve it. Let me put myself back in a different state. And so the way I do that is I use my body. Because I've done this with athletes for decades, with billionaire businessmen. If you see somebody gets in a slump of some sort, great athlete, Paul Tudor Jones, one of the greatest financial traders in the history of the world, you know, I've coached him for 22 years. When I came to see him, this is a man who made 200% in 1987 when the stock market had its biggest single crash in a day, percentage-wise still. He made 200% for his clients, more money than anybody could dream of. Then he went to the moon and he went down to earth and then he lost money. So I was brought in to turn him around. Well, how do you turn a guy like that around?
Yeah.
I watched him. His shoulders were down. He was breathing like this. He's sitting like this all the time because he'd been through these failures and it started to get stored in his body. Now, in this state, this man is a genius, couldn't do it. So I watched films when he was at his best and he's like standing up and he's doing this. He's, this is what I'm going to do. Sell this, make this happen. And the movement, the intensity, the way he used his face. And so I showed him a video of himself today and showed him a video when he was at his best. And I said, what do you notice? He was like, those are two different people. I said, yes, but we can get back to this guy by just using the body first. Trying to use your mind, you'll go in circles. But I've been teaching for years that a radical change in your body instantly changes your biochemistry. 38 years I've taught it. 2 years ago at Harvard, they did a study, scientifically proven what I've been teaching all these decades, where they call it power postures.
Yeah, the Wonder Woman stance.
Yeah, standing right? Like Wonder Woman or Superman for 2 minutes.
Yep.
Or like you see a guy that's like this, pull back like that for 2 minutes, literally increases your testosterone in your biochemistry within 2 minutes by 20%. It drops cortisol by 18%, which is the stress hormone, and increases your chance of taking a more risky behavior, which is what's required of a leader, by 33%. 2 minutes. Now that's just standing a certain way. I show people use their voice, their body, their movement, which is 10 times more dynamic than just a stiff stance. And when you change your state, your mental, emotional state, you change your performance. Haven't you had times when you have like can't remember how to spell a difficult word like the or your own email
really
or something
tired,
like that?
Really tired, like can't remember like what your it is. Cousin's name.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And then you've had times where you're in the flow where after you do something, you're like, you know, I did that. I don't know how I did it, but I did it.
Absolutely.
I was in the flow. Well, you're the same person. The only difference is state. So training yourself to be in a peak state every day. I mean, you know, you think about like a great businessman. Think of a great entertainer like Elton John has been around in rock and roll
just
for what,
birthday.
Like 40, how many years is it? 40
early
years?
70s, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's mind-boggling. And most people still like some sample of his music. Well, he's got to have days when he gets up to entertain when he thinks, if you make me sing that Daniel song one more time, I'm going postal, right? But he never does. Every single time, he's in that same beautiful state. That's not because he's naturally like that. He's trained himself to do that, like a great athlete trains himself. That's what leaders have to do. The state of the union, the state of the company, is the culture. And the culture starts at the head. Whoever that leader is, their state impacts everybody else. So training yourself to be in that peak state is the key to it all.
Please keep in mind, this is about half of the entire presentation. If you're up for a treat, you should definitely listen to the whole thing. You can do so by clicking the link labeled View the Full Video on YouTube in the show notes. So that does it for this episode of 7 Good Minutes. Until next time, let's be civil to one another out there. Thanks for listening.